गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, स्टे सेफली एट होम. सो आई एम स्टार्टिंग द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द वेव चैप्टर. नाउ व्हाट इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ द प्रोग्रेसिव वेव? इट इज गिवन बाय ए साइन 2 पाई स्मॉल टी बाय बिग टी माइनस एक्स बाय लैम्डा. ऑल राइट, सो दिस आर्गुमेंट ऑफ साइन, इट रिप्रेजेंट द फेज. ऑल राइट, सो यू सी वन कैन राइट दैट व्हाट इज द फेज ऑफ द वेव undergo means the wave which is progressive, what is the phase. So as I already mentioned that argument of sign, this represent the phase of the wave or phase of the particle of the medium through which the progressive wave is propagating. So you see, you can write phase is given by 2 pi small t by big T minus x by lambda. So from this relation it is clear that phase is a function of time as well as phase is a function of position x. All right, so if you consider that there are, means you are taking the two particles at the same time, so you see same time means t I am making the same but at different positions, and let their phases be given by this way. You see, if I, what I have written tx1, tx1 means what? At the same time, I have taken two particles at different position. So, what will be their phases? It will be given by phi 1, it will be 2 pi small t by big T minus x1 by lambda, whereas phi 2 will be given by 2 pi small t by big T minus x2 by lambda. Is that clear? So you see, what will be the phase difference? Phase difference will be phi 2 minus phi 1. So phi 2 minus phi 1, if you do, then you see this one is getting cancelled because both are having the same term, 2 pi small t by big T. So how much you are getting? Phi 2 means it will be 2 pi minus x2 by lambda, and here it will come minus 2 pi x1 by lambda. Is that clear? So you are getting 2 pi x1 minus x2 by lambda, means you can write 2 pi delta x divided by lambda. Is that clear? Now again another one you can say that, so this is the relation, this is the phase difference between two particle at different positions x1 and x2. So how you are getting, what is the phase difference? It will be 2 pi x1 minus x2 divided by lambda. Is that clear? Now again you may consider that, let us consider two particles at different time but at the same position. Just look at the relations I have written. I have taken different time t1 and t2 but the position same. Means you have considered the particles at the same position but at different time. Then what will be the phase difference given by? You have to subtract phi 2 minus phi 1, and phi 2 will be how much? 2 pi t2 by t minus x by lambda minus 2 pi t1 t minus x by lambda. So you see 2 pi x by lambda will get cancelled. So you are getting 2 pi delta t divided by t. Is that clear? So these are the two relations you have to remember regarding the phase difference. That phase difference, one can find out the phase difference as a function of position. Here you have taken two particles at the same time at two different positions. What is the phase difference? 2 pi del x by lambda. And when you are taking the phase difference between the two particles at the same position but different time, that will be given by 2 pi delta t divided by t. So these are the relations you are supposed to remember to solve the numericals, that delta phi is given by 2 pi del x by lambda, or delta phi is given by 2 pi delta t by t. Now next is, what is the relation between particle velocity and wave velocity? Now according to the concept of equation of progressive wave, you can write down the displacement of a particle as a sine 2 pi by lambda Vt minus 6. Already I have discussed in the last lecture. This is another way to write down the equation of the progressive wave. So you see, if y is the displacement, then what will be the instantaneous velocity of the particle? It will be dy dt. So if you take the derivative of this, it is sine 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x. So it will become a cos 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x. But as it is derivative with respect to t, so again you have to take the derivative of this term 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x. So ddt of 2 pi by lambda Vt is 2 pi V by lambda. And ddt of this one is not at all coming. So you see, what is the instantaneous particle velocity dy dt? It is given by this formula. So let us consider this as equation 1. Again, if you consider the slope of the displacement curve, what is the slope of a displacement curve? Dy dx. So if you take the derivative with respect to x, it will become a cos 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x. Then d dx 2 pi by lambda minus x will become minus 2 pi by lambda. This is equation number 2. Alright. So you see, if you divide equation 1 by 2. So you are getting dy by dt divided by dy by dx is equal to, these two will cancel, 2 pi by lambda, 2 pi by lambda will cancel. So it will become minus v. Alright, what is v? V is the wave velocity. Alright, and so, and what is dy dt? Dy dt is the particle velocity. So what is the relation we have got? That particle velocity is equal to wave velocity into dy dx. Dy dx is what? Slope of displacement curve. Is that clear? So what is the relation between, yes, there is a negative sign. So what is the relation between particle velocity and wave velocity? This is the relation between particle velocity and wave velocity. That particle velocity is equal to minus wave velocity into slope of displacement curve. So from this chapter, what you are supposed to learn and remember, that is the different forms of equation of progressive wave, characteristics of progressive wave, that already I discussed in the last lecture. Then the phase difference when you are considering the particles at different position but at the same time, it will be 2 pi del x by lambda. And what will be the phase difference when you are considering the particle at the same position but at different time? It will be 2 pi delta t by big T. Alright. And then last relation, particle velocity and wave velocity relation. What is the relation? Particle velocity is equal to minus wave velocity into slope of the displacement curve. So that's the end of this chapter. Thank you, children.